starting to feel better at my neck, and I started to train harder and harder, and I changed my style, and I said to myself, I need to change, I need to come back with a completely fresh look, a completely different Taz. And that's when I completely, the Tasmaniac died, and Taz was born. Joey Styles was a play-by-play guy, and I'm doing a match with him, but you never see me on camera. Then you come out of the match, and end of the match.
The man who pulled this match with me is named Peter Sinercha. But you know him very well. But you know him as Taz.
Taz becoming our Ultimate Fight style persona carried with it the big fight atmosphere. And I loved the big fight atmosphere. I thought that that's one of the many things that was missing in wrestling during the mid-1990s.
The Raw set was the big R-A-W, just huge letters that were by the entrance way. What happened was Seth would get on top of the R, what people don't know, and he fell off the R on the Team Taz. Well, now it's live TV, you know, which I've never done live wrestling before. And it was just a funny story that he fell off the R, but it was a joke. But hey, you fell off the R, you know, sure.
Well, I know this will make him mad once all over again, because it made him mad when I first saw him. But the first thing I remember about these guys was how small they were. Everybody was like they looked like little miniature wrestlers running around, you know? And I remember saying on the commentary that night, Vince and I were doing the commentary, and I looked at, I think it was either Taz or, I think it was Taz. And I looked at Vince, and I said, he looked a lot bigger on the Lucky Charms box. I think he came and said something to me about that.
It was a great night.
Gentlemen, Extreme Championship Wrestling presents the grudge match of the century.
Sabu and I wrestling each other at Bayley Label was a very big moment, not just for Sabu, not just for myself, but for the ECW fans and for the promotion.
Sabu! I'm gonna choke you out! See you on the 13th!
For 1 year, just about 1 year straight, Taz called out Sabu to come out, and Taz mocked Sabu.
Sabu!
Taz did everything physically possible, mentally and emotionally possible, to taunt Sabu, and Sabu wouldn't come out to face me. I called him out, cursed him out, did everything I can. Beat guys up in the ring, recalled on Sabu, the whole nine yards. And then finally when he came out to look me face to face, the lights went out first, then the lights came on, and Sabu and Taz, at the November to Remember, were in the same ring at the same time for the first time, the long time. And then we knew these two guys would face that Bayley Legal. And it was a great moment. And it was, God, we made each other in that match. You know, we made each other in that match, and I'll never forget it.
And there it is, the Captain Hajime, the Taz Bitchin. And with the condition of Sabu Sakinton, I don't see how he could possibly fight off the Taz Bitchin. The Captain Hajime took out Big Bad Legal by one more. Paul Roberts, Chris Jericho, Rick Oliver, and it's over.
It was a phenomenal moment for the company. And I was fortunate enough to be a part of that promotion, and all of that, being in one of the main events, and wrestled my arch nemesis, Sabu. And it was a great moment.
It was a match.
Bam Bam and I wrestling for the TV title. I was the TV champion. And I ended up getting him in the Taz mission, and I was on his back, walking around the ring with me on his back, and choking him out. And then all of a sudden, he just throws himself backwards, and we go right through the ring. ECW classic moment. The whole arena, you know, just stood up. Like looking in the ring, like trying to look in the ring. And it's just like the silence, and then this like holy, you know, what chance starts, you know. We laid in that hole for a shoot, I'd say, I don't know, about 25, 30 seconds, maybe even longer, which is a long time, you know. And then Bam Bam called out first, you know, and the place went nuts, because that's the hometown guy, and they know I'm dead, and I was his cushion, you know. So the guy who went in second came out first, and I was giving up about 120 pounds to Bam Bam at the time. And then I didn't come out on my own. Bam Bam pulled me out and covered me, 1, 2, 3, and pinned me and became the TV champion. The place erupted, and I lost the match.
And he lost, graciously, and came out just a few weeks later, walked up to Bigelow in the ring, and said, "You beat me. It was an honor to wrestle you, but just so you know, now I'm even more inspired to beat you back."
As time went on, I kind of invented my own belt called the FTW Championship. FTW stood for F the World. And that was Taz's attitude. He didn't care about anybody. He was miserable, pissed at the world. Just, you know, just angry. Angry rage.
Our world champion, Shane Douglas, was on the shelf with an injury.
The company was doing me wrong. I felt I wasn't getting an opportunity for Shane Douglas's ECW World Heavyweight title and blah, 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 blah. And I come out with my own championship in my home city of, well, not Brooklyn, but Queens, New York, and debut this belt. And it took a life on of its own.
Hold up, so what I got right here, you see, I'm not the world champion because... I am the world heavyweight champion, and this is the proof. You can call it the Brooklyn World Belt, you can call it the World Belt, you can call it anything you want. But enough with the chitter chatter, Shane Douglas! Why don't you come out here, belt for belt, Brooklyn vs. Pittsburgh, and bring it out!
I don't think if you go back in the history of ECW, the FTW title meant that much. I think in the history of ECW, the FTW title was the launch of Taz's push towards the World Heavyweight Championship.
And there's only been two FTW champions in the history, myself and Sabu. Sabu wasn't happy when he had the FTW belt, because we had the first belt, which was an old TV belt that we painted orange and just put FTW stickers on it, right? And then we had a real belt made that said FTW on it, with my name on it. You know, I was figuring out no one else is going to have it. It's mine. It's not a real championship. I invented it. But then one dude left another, Sabu ended up beating me for it. He was just pissed that my name was on it, engraved in it. So he would take a big piece of white tape, put it over my name, and just put a Sharpie wrote Sabu. So, yeah, he was a little nuts. We had fun with it, but the FTW title was really cool. The gun.